Today, we are going to be testing out ChatGPT Canvas, doing some live AI SEO. If you haven't tested it out yet, it's pretty amazing stuff. And I think they've actually come after a lot of SEO tools. So from what I can see with this update, basically, this has replaced a lot of SaaS tools in the SEO industry. And nobody's really talking about it, but it's very, very powerful for SEO. So what I'm going to do is open up ChatGPT. And this is a brand new update. It only came out on October the 3rd, as you can see right here. I'm going to be running you through some of my best workflows. And if you have any questions as we go along, feel free to ask them. Otherwise, we're going to kick this straight up with some good old-fashioned AI SEO. So from ChatGPT, once you've logged in, you can then go to ChatGPT 4.0 with Canvas, right? So you select this option right here. And then if you just say something like, write an SEO blog, it's going to look completely different in a minute because you can see it pulls up this example of content, right? And it's basically got like, it kind of feels like Claude Artifacts. If you never use Claude Artifacts, this was something that I was getting really good results with previously. And Claude is great for writing content, but I would say ChatGPT 4.0 with Canvas now is kind of changed again. And I'll come on to why that is in a minute, right? And there's some really cool stuff here. So, for example, if you're editing your content, you can actually just rewrite sections of this without having to go back and forth with ChatGPT previously. So, for example, if we went into ChatGPT and we use exactly the same prompt, write an SEO blog like this, and I'll pull them up side by side so you can see what I'm yapping on about, right? You can see here, so we'll say, okay, write about link building, something like that. What this is going to do is it's going to write a blog, but you can't edit it. And let's say you want to just rewrite the introduction paragraph without changing all the content. Well, it's actually not possible, right? And if you were like, oh, I want an internal link right here in the middle of the article, you couldn't previously do that. Whereas with Canvas now, you can, right? So if you're like, oh, I want an internal link, boom, right there. Okay, ask ChatGPT, give it the sitemap. I'll show you how to do that. So for example, if we go to my sitemap on my website, and by the way, this stuff that I'm showing you, like, number one, it's literally brand new. And number two, like, ChatGPT have genuinely dropped a game-changing update here. And the other thing here is, right, if we take a sitemap like this, like, this is stuff that nobody else has figured out yet, right? So if you start using this right now, you're way ahead of the curve when it comes to SEO and that sort of thing. So, for example, if I'm like, right, insert one relevant internal link in this paragraph, feel free to rewrite. And by the way, all the prompts and all the tips and all the workflows from today, you'll get for free at the end of the video. If we hit enter like so, what this is going to do is actually rewrite the whole paragraph and insert an internal link from our sitemap, right? And so this is probably better than 99.9% of internal link plugins I've used, right? Because it's just so easy. And this is way faster and easier. Plus, it's customized to my website. Plus, I don't have to do any editing, right? It's just automatically inserted inside this paragraph right here, which is absolutely marvelous, if you ask me. So, for example, if we click on this anchor text right here, you can actually preview the link. So, sometimes ChatGPT makes a mistake like hallucinating internal links or hallucinating external links, etc. But you can actually test it out using this process right here, and it's super easy and fast to do, as you can see right here, right? And so, you can see how you can just edit like little parts of the content, improve it massively, and then you don't need to go back and forth with ChatGPT. If we said to ChatGPT on the old version, like, okay, I want an internal link up here, right here. Well, number one, I have to copy and paste that into ChatGPT inside the search here. Then I have to paste in my sitemap as well, right? Then I have to ask it to rewrite it. And it's going to rewrite the whole article just to change that one single line. It's not very time efficient. And bear in mind, like, you can't do this with any other AI tool. So, for example, if you're using Claude, you can't use that with Claude AI SEO. You can't use it with any other SEO tool that I've used before, right? And so, if you want to save yourself a lot of time, this is one of the most powerful and best ways to do it because it's just an extremely easy way to make massive changes to your content in the most time-efficient way, right? And that's better than Claude. That's better than ChatGPT 4.0. Super easy, and it's a massive game changer, right? And if you've got a team, you should probably be making sure they're using it too, because it's going to save them a lot of time and they'll be able to produce more content and better quality content in a shorter amount of time because they're using ChatGPT Canvas, right? And so highly recommended if you haven't checked this out already. Now, there's loads of other cool stuff you can actually do with this. And let me come on to that in a second. So for example, what you can actually do is you can look at, let's say you've got this paragraph right here and you're like, well, I want to rank for the keyword SEO training. And this doesn't even mention the keyword SEO training. So I can say, rewrite this introduction, 3 sentences as Alex Hormozy, include keyword SEO training, plus hook them in and add some curiosity to improve the introduction. We'll hit enter like so. And you can see it just totally rewrites the content, includes the keyword, writes something that's actually way more interesting than it was previously. And it literally took like one click to change that. Bit of a game changer. Paulina says, shout out to Paulina says, how are you solving the issue with memory loss? I was trying to save the settings by asking Canvas to use the adjustments for each project, but it doesn't work. I will appreciate some tips. So if you want ChatGPT to have like a bit of a memory, because every time you open up ChatGPT Canvas, it's going to give you like different ways that you can use it and that sort of thing, right? And it's going to start from basically scratch. So there's two ways to handle that. Number one is you can just bookmark the link like so, and then you come back to it. And ChatGPT Canvas is already trained on the prompts you want it to do, which means that you don't have to go in and start in a whole new chat where you have to retrain Canvas and everything you want it to do. Number two is you can actually save the prompts that you like from ChatGPT. And I'll show you some of my best ones in a second. So if you have a look, these are some of my best prompts, as you can see right here, along with loads of other cool stuff in there, right? And if we open up this document, let me find it right here. Here we go. So these are some of my best prompts, right? And so I can just insert them or upload them inside ChatGPT and they're good to go. And I think you can actually attach files right there. So if you want to retrain ChatGPT with a PDF of all your prompts, you absolutely can. By the way, if you want access to this, you can check out my free course, log into the free SEO course, then go to SEO Systems, and then go to ChatGPT Canvas, right? So two different ways to handle the memory loss. Number one, you can bookmark the link that you had the chat in and then come back to it later. Number two, you can actually just go directly inside ChatGPT and all your favorite prompts and then upload that to ChatGPT Canvas. Now, the third option is you can go into your settings. Where is it now? Click on your face over here. Then click on customize ChatGPT. And from here, you can insert some custom instructions, right? So you can ask it like, okay, here's what I want you to do. Here's how I want you to handle each response. And then also, how would you like ChatGPT to respond? And you can just insert some information right there. Bear in mind, like the new ChatGPT with Canvas version is basically brand new. So it's still in beta mode from what I'm seeing. You can see it says beta right there. So I imagine that it will have better memory in the future, or you might be able to create some like custom GPTs out of it. But yeah, that's basically the way that I would handle it. Hope it helps you. If you did, smash a like on this video. So you can see how powerful ChatGPT Canvas is as we're going through it. I'm going to go back to the Canvas example right here. So some other stuff that you can do as well. You can just rewrite the content. So you can go to reading level and then you can change the reading level, right? So if you are writing for like quite an advanced audience, you might want to change that to college, right? Or if you're writing for like, you know, just the average public, then you might want to simplify the content a bit so it's easier, right? And if you just scroll down to say middle school, that means pretty much anyone can understand it and you can easily just rewrite the whole article right there, right? The other cool thing about this as well is like, you can actually use this for posting cross-platform, right? So it doesn't just have to be one platform that you post on. For example, if you look at some of the SEO case studies I run, basically when I'm running them, I create content across multiple platforms so I get more opportunities to rank. So for example, that could be chat. It could be like, for example, LinkedIn. It could be Medium. It could be Twitter, etc. The main thing here is you can easily use this to start ranking. Now, if you want to see an example of that, you can see me. I actually created some content right here 3 days ago ranking for the keyword best Amazon SEO tools, which is a potential money-making keyword, as you can imagine. And you can see like just created the content with AI, posted it to LinkedIn. You know, run it through some quality control before you actually post it. But you can see that actually ranks is easy to create and you can use ChatGPT Canvas to do this. I think that article was actually created with auto-blogging AI. But if you want to use Canvas, potentially good, right? Decor says, is it possible? Is it possible to do what? if you're asking, is it possible to rank? Or is it possible to create images inside the article using Canvas? Last time I checked, it wasn't very good at. Now, I think there's a couple of ways that you could handle that, right? So, for example, if we go onto my website right here, we'll just grab an example image. So let's say we've got an image like this. I think what you could do here is you could ask ChatGPT, insert an image below using this link. I don't know if that's going to work. Honestly, I've tried it before and it didn't work at all, and it totally failed. Didn't seem to work at all there either, as you can see. Now, I think a potential solution for that is you can ask ChatGPT, okay, insert this image as HTML, embed this image as HTML. I might be able to do that. Let's have a look. Yeah, still doesn't seem to be able to insert images like that. Maybe if we just go into ChatGPT and we're like, okay, insert an image about, nah, it doesn't seem to work inside Canvas, right? I think probably your best bet would be to like get some HTML code and then get it rewritten. Or you could do the whole thing in Markdown and then get the image embedded like that. But I don't think Canvas is great for images. However, if you're, for example, like pasting this into WordPress or something like that, then you could just paste YouTube URL and that should automatically embed when you go directly into WordPress. Super simple, easy way to do it right there. I'll show you an example of that. So I'm going to just log into WordPress in the background and I can show you exactly what we mean. So let me open up an example WordPress login right here and we'll go to add new post. Obviously, you wouldn't just copy the content and paste it like this. You want to do some quality control, which you'll find inside the ChatGPT section inside my free SEO course. But if we go into ChatGPT, if we go into Canvas, like so, you could just insert the content right there. Let's have a look at another example. This is a test website, which I think has Gutenberg. So you probably need Gutenberg to do this. Let me log in right now. So if we go into Gutenberg, we'll add a new post. And let's say you were editing the content. You're like, right, I want a video from my YouTube channel. Let's plug it in right there. We'll take that, plug it into Gutenberg. And there you go, right? You can just automatically embed YouTube videos just by inserting it like that. I think that would probably be one of the easiest solutions. I can imagine in the future versions of ChatGPT with Canvas, it's going to change a lot. The other thing that I would say is like when you're plugging this content directly into, for example, WordPress or LinkedIn or wherever you're posting, right? You can actually see that it still embeds the internal links, it embeds the YouTube videos, it formats the headings nicely, so this is like an H4, etc. You got the bullet points. So all the content is actually really nicely formatted to go straight into WordPress. It wouldn't surprise me. This genuinely wouldn't surprise me because I know you can already link ChatGPT to, for example, you can link it to Google Drive and other places like that, or even OneDrive. It wouldn't surprise me if in the future you can actually link ChatGPT with Canvas directly to WordPress, right? And that would kind of negate the use and the need for like AI SEO tools because you could just take the content directly from there, directly to the website. Paulina says, are you using rank math for WordPress? I actually don't use it simply because a few years ago, I actually de-indexed all the content on my site, right? And like my rankings just dropped down to zero overnight because of that. And I never forgave rank math after that. And I actually, after that, I just decided, right, I'm only gonna use Yoast because it doesn't have any issues like that. And I also think as well, like from what I've heard, the indexing sounds really good, but I haven't seen it work. Right? I haven't seen some really good case studies with rank math. So yeah, I think a lot of people recommend it, but personally, I don't. I just think like you need the basics, right? If you look at a lot of the case study websites that I've built over the last year or so, a lot of them don't use rank math at all and they get great results. So I don't think I need it to get results. And also the more plugins you have, the slower your website is going to be, right? So I try and minimize the amount of plugins and complexity I have inside my SEO processes so that I can save a lot of time and get better results with SEO, right? And just focus on what matters most. So we have talked about how to automate internal links, how to embed media directly inside ChatGPT Canvas when you're plugging it directly into WordPress or whatever other platform you're posting on. We've talked about how to automate editing your content, rewriting it, how to improve the SEO optimization content, etc. Some other interesting stuff you could do, right? You could use a free content optimizer, for example, like Zista. Let's log in Zista. We'll wait for that in the background right there. Just going to wait for that to load, and then we'll log in a sec. And then I'll show you some cool like semantic stuff that you could do with Zista in a minute, right? And this is quite interesting because, for example, if you go to Content Optimizer inside Zista, which is like it's kind of like a free version of a Phrase or Surfer or that sort of thing. The reason that I show it is because it's free, so everyone can use it on our channel, right? Now, if you go to Zista and then you go to Content Optimizer, what you could do is take the semantic recommendations from here and plug them into your content, right? So if we go to what is SEO, as an example piece of content, Web3B says, yo to you too. And I'm just going to go back to an example right here. Let's have a look. Something that we've created previously. See what we got here. I want to find one with an actual content, with actual content inside it, right? And then we can just figure out, okay, how do you improve it with the semantics inside ChatGPT Canvas? So let me wait for this to load. See what we got here. So let's say we got an article like cats eat bananas, right? And you want to improve your semantic optimization score. You could, for example, take the introduction like that, right? Let's say you got your content plugged into ChatGPT Canvas. You could take your content, and let's say we need to mention cat food inside that article, right? I'm going to say, rewrite this so that it mentions cat food too, but optimize this introduction for the keyword, can cats eat bananas, all right? And now we're going to take this, and we will plug it directly into Zista. Then we'll check the score, and you can see that the optimization score is improved from 49% to 51%, right? Because it was semantically optimized the content using the LSI keywords that you can plug directly into ChatGPT as well, right? And so if you've got a list of like LSIs you want to create, like for example, all of these, you could take the content inside ChatGPT Canvas and just rewrite it just like I've shown you to, so that your content is more semantically optimized for your keyword, which means that it's not only useful for the user, but it's also going to be contextually relevant for the algorithm. And you need to do both, really. You can't just do one or the other, right? That's one of the easiest ways to use ChatGPT Canvas to automate semantically optimizing your content as well. So we have Decor Minimalist, who says, how can I verify that articles are not by AI, written by a human for free? So what you can do, you can use, for example, I think it's 0GPT, something like that. Last time I used this, it was free to use. I don't know. Sometimes I check these and made them premium, right? So let's check. So we're going to plug in this content directly in 0GPT, hit detect. Bear in mind, I don't really care whether content is AI or human. What I care about is how good is the content, right? That's the only thing that matters. For example, if you go onto Google, even Google is ranking AI content number one, right? So this trend is not going away of creating content with AI. In fact, if anything, it's only going to be embedded more into other search engines, right? And so I think the way forward is AI. And, you know, if it's AI detectable or not, I don't think that really matters, right? So for example, if we check Google's own content and we plug that into the AI detector, we'll hit detect, right? That's interesting, actually. Google's content comes back as 0%. Let's check some more of this content. Let's take this, right? So we'll take this content like so. We'll plug that into the AI detector. We'll hit detect text. Wow. I'll tell you what, if you want content non-AI detectable, just use Google AI overviews. I just learned something there. Anyway, for example, you can check this content for free using 0GPT.com, and that is a free AI detector, right? And so problem solved. You can now verify that articles are written not by AI or human, just for free using 0GPT, right? Pretty cool, yeah. Free AI detector. The other thing that I would say here to note, right, is like if that says 45% AI GPT, well, that doesn't mean that the content is AI written or not. In fact, if there's only a 45% chance of that content being written by AI, it's quite a low confidence score, right? Whereas if it was 100% or something like that, you know, that would be interesting. So that's pretty much it. That's how to use ChatGPT Canvas to rank with SEO, how to automate semantics, how to rewrite introductions. I've answered all the questions inside the chat today. And additionally, if you want to check out the SEO Elite Circle, I'll leave a link inside the comments and description. This is absolutely popping off right now. You can see this testimonial, we just got it 10 hours ago. Basically, Chris joined about 2 or 3 days ago and already closed his first deal from SEO using the processes inside the SEO Elite Circle. Absolutely amazing. You can see all the reviews here, right? There's just so many people winning here. You got Vibath, you got Marvin, you got Mike, you got Don, Frank as well. And you can see just a ridiculous amount of 5-star reviews inside the SEO Elite Circle. So if you want to check that out, link in the comments and description. We've got a 72% off deal right now, so you can check that out. And if you want access to all the prompts that I've talked about today, all of these ones, including 50 ChatGPT Canvas prompts that you can actually steal from me, feel free to check that out. Link in the comments and description. And I will see you on the next one. By the way, if you're like really struggling with SEO, I know I get a ridiculous amount of DMs and that sort of thing. So I try and help everyone I can. If you want help with SEO, feel free to book in a one-to-one SEO strategy session. Link is in the comments and description. And inside that call, we can show you how we take websites from zero to 145,000 visitors and generate thousands of dollars in sales on autopilot, right? Without Facebook or Google ads. So if you want to check that out, link's in the comments and description. We'll show you on this free link building acceleration session, a free SEO domination plan, just go to the sequence of link building, we'll answer any questions you have, you'll learn the best link building strategies for your website, plus how to outrank your competitors with link. By the way, this stuff absolutely nails. Let me show you some examples, right? So I'm just going to go into my Facebook group. And if you're not a member of this, you are missing out massively. Honestly, I even announce when I'm doing live streams in there. And you can see we're even offering a free SEO mastermind at the minute. But if we scroll down, I'm going to show you something really cool right here. And it is absolutely mind-blowing, some of the recent results we got, right? By the way, this is a number of you of the SEO Elite Circle. So if we go inside the comments here, you can see this example, right, of a recent client that we're working with. Now, I'm not gonna reveal their domain on live on a YouTube. Obviously, that's for private clients only. But you can see here, just in the last year, so since October, they've gone from like 8K traffic all the way up to 33,000 traffic just with link building, right? So we teach this sort of stuff, and we're gonna teach you this sort of stuff on the call directly one to one. Additionally, you can see a few case studies here of AI sites like absolutely popping off. I'll make a video about that maybe later today, show you some stuff about how we're doing it and all that sort of thing. But yeah, if you want to get results with SEO, we're teaching it all and we're giving away all the secrets inside this one-to-one call. Plus, you can just ask any questions you have and you can get my free SEO course. Links in the comments description. All right, appreciate you watching. I will see you on the next one.